You love that, man. You have people standing up all over this one row that's right down here.
They're standing up because they probably know that last year at the Quartet Convention down in Sevierville, Tennessee, you guys, gospel music lovers, voted. And you voted him your favorite young gospel artist of the year.
You got the popular vote.
Yes, he did. He won the popular vote.
See, that's great that he won that. I mean, if I'd have voted, I'd have voted for him. But, I mean, nobody more deserving.
He deserved
it. Well, no, I didn't vote in that.
Why not?
Well, probably because I don't get a ballot to vote with. Maybe a reason for that, I don't know. But what I was going to say is, I'm glad he won. Very deserving of that. Great player, great talent.
Oh, yeah.
But they have to, again, always in these election things, or if you got to vote for something, they always have to, they have to stick that favorite young artist in there. I mean, it's, make out like, yeah, it could just be favorite artist. You don't have to put young, like it's a big deal to be young. Everybody in here's been young. Well, some of them's trying to think back. They said, I'm sure I was. It's no big deal to be young, you know. You get to be old, now you've done something. There's something to get an award for, but no, they don't have a favorite award. Geezer still standing award, they don't have that.
I feel certain you would win if they had that. You sound a little, I'm trying to call you out, but you sound a little bitter.
No, I'm not bitter, I'm just.
Are you grumpy today?
I'm campaigning, I'm just saying. I don't mean anything by this other than just the truth. Our audience is a mature audience. It's not a young, it's not kids. There is a lot of kids here tonight. That's great, man. I love to see them. That's awesome. Yeah. You're a kid, aren't you? How old are you? How old are you, buddy?
10.
See, that's awesome, man. I'm glad to see 10-year-olds here, but usually it's just a bunch of old people. It's not very many. And it's hard for them to, you know, I mean, just look at Trey. It's hard for our audience to relate to something like that. I mean,
he's not a that.
Well, 26. I mean, there's women toting pocketbooks that's older than that. Just look, I mean, but look, he looks great. It's just a young thing. It's different. I mean, starting at, look at the hairdo. I mean, that's. I'm not the one that started on your hair. Somebody started and didn't finish. Look at me. I told him the other day it looked like his barber changed shifts right in the middle of his lunch break. But I mean, it looks good on a young person. That looks great. Yes, I mean, he's lost weight. He's all thin and trim and fit. Bright smile, you know. Full set of teeth. Hey, he's got original equipment. Not only teeth, he's got hips and knees too. I mean, that's something.
You have a point you're trying
well,
to make.
Well, I'm just letting him be aware. Count your blessings, man. You need to enjoy all that stuff while you can. Because it won't last long. Just before you know it, you'll wander up into a room somewhere. You know, maybe even turn around a time or two after you get in there while you're muttering to yourself, now what I come in here after?
Sounds like it's coming from a voice of experience.
It happens to me all the time. Do you do that now for real?
I actually do from time to time. It's kind of crazy.
Oh yeah, man. I mean, even just simple things, getting up, getting dressed, you go to get your shirt, and you've got this shirt in your mind that you're going to put on, and it's like, what was I going to put on? And then you go back, look at your pants, you know, to see.
Last night. This happened to me last night.
Did I tell you about getting a shirt?
You mentioned it. I am laying in, we all have our own little bunk on the bus, you know, and I was laying in my bunk and I was reading some stuff about the election on my phone, and I realized that normally when I read, I put on my, I have these little glasses, these little readers, you know, that you get at Walmart or whatever.
That's coming too.
Yeah, that's coming. And so I normally keep them in that little pocket on the inside of my, little pouch on the inside of the bunk there. And so I'm fumbling around in there, it's dark, and I'm looking for my glasses, and I reach up and turn my light on, I'm looking for my glasses, I had them on. I was so glad no one was watching. So, get ready there. You know what? I mean, seriously, we're making fun of you, but you need to understand something, Trey. I'm twice his age, and so, I mean, he's still kind of learning some stuff, but I remember being, 26, and you didn't think people that were 50, you just thought they were all dumb, they didn't know anything. And, yeah, that's right. But you just need to understand that we were all your age once upon a time, and I vividly remember when I was with the Cathedrals, I, of course, was the youngest, and I remember having the coolest hair in the group. I do. You look like you don't believe it. It's the truth. I remember when I was the cutest one in the group. So you just...
Hang on, I don't remember that part. I remember that part. See, people get on this all the time. Vintage, always teasing Trey. We're not teasing. I mean, that's...
Well, we love each other, you can tell.
Oh, absolutely.
We do. You guys know what this is?